once, and I told them that story, and they scoffed at Mr. Douglas and said he was absolutely incorrect, and there are nothing but lilacs in it. Mr. J.B. Yeah, I got a little cheat sheet. Some of you may know, I took a fall off of a hiking trail about this time last year, September 2023. And we were hiking up in the South Cumberland Forest up there towards Mount Eagle, Tennessee, and which my wife and I loved doing. We'd hike the trail, we were hiking the trail, we'd hike two, three times. And we're doing the ascent. They're, you know, they're not, it's kind of like hills here. They're not mountains, you know. This maybe 3,000 feet was the highest peak, but so we're making our way up, and you're kind of following the path, and you're looking down. It's about 20 feet below you, and at the bottom of that's a creek bed, and a creek was running. And I turned around to tell her something. Usually, I want to tell her either something funny or something clever. I'm trying to score points whenever I engage. Whenever I engage with Amen. My wife, I want it to have meaning.
Amen.
And I turned around and I went, oh, and I, my ankle twisted and I fell. She said I fell head over heels, a cartwheel about three or four times, about 15 feet down to the bottom of this thing, and mm-hmm. caught my head in these two rocks and was out cold. And she said, I thought you were dead. And then she said, and then I said, and then I went, no. And I said, well, that's how you talk to the dog. and me quite often. But I did say, you know, if I'd been laying down there and I'd had any notion of checking out and being dead, that would have changed it right there. I would have. Anyway, I got down there for 6-7 minutes, and this couple who we passed and their adult son come running up, because she's yelling and screaming on the top of the trail, and they came running up, and he, the young man, was studying to be an emergency services technician. And, so basically, he and his dad pretty much saved me. They called the Rangers, they called the county EMT services, and apparently he had a super phone because mine wouldn't work on the trail. And next thing you know, I'm being life flighted to Chattanooga Hospital, and the rest is history. But it took me the better part of a year to get over it, and I, for the longest time, I couldn't remember songs. And when I first started back playing, I'd play for about 10 minutes, and then I'd forget what I was doing, kind of like I do now. But it took me a minute. But so anyway, I got a little thing where I can follow the lyrics in case I am forgetful. That's a long-winded explanation, but I'll just cap that by saying that. Thank you. I'm happy to be here. Happy to be doing it.
So he drank her down to the ragged side of town, shared a taxi to carry her home. And she left her handkerchief there beside you on the seat, as if to emphasize that you were all alone. Smelled like springtime, and you were just a boy. In the city streets, the dirty winter snow. All the lilacs in Ohio, Ohio, where she about love, a story you speak of when you talk to Sam at the bar. But I've seen the details, your story always fails. You're close, but no cigar. And you might see your own ass in a double whiskey glass, but you never erase her smile. And you'll never write it down, never find her in this town of phantom dreams and fingernail fire. It was springtime and you were just a boy, and all the lilacs in Ohio, all the lilacs in Ohio, there you go. In the city streets, the dirt of winter snow, all the lilacs in Ohio. So you pin her handkerchief to clean white linen sheets, and you unmake your bed and you crawl in, and you imagine her there, and you're tangled in her hair, and she smells like flowers again. And it's springtime and you are just a boy, and all the lilacs in Ohio.